Hello, ladies, gentlemen, and everybody else watching. My name's Eric, and welcome back to a brand new video here on the BioShock Hub. Almost a year ago now, I made a video on the Nintendo Switch port of BioShock the Collection. I gave you guys a review, and I tried to keep it as spoiler-free as possible. Well, recently I decided to start playing it again, and it made me think, should I give you another review, and is it worth buying in 2021? So, with that being said, sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. So originally, during my original review, I stated that it was a must-own game or collection on the Nintendo Switch. Did that opinion change? We'll find out towards the end of the video here. Now, first and foremost, let's talk about the actual game performance itself. And if this is different from the actual Nintendo Switch itself because I play on the light version, please correct me in the comment section below. So, first and foremost, the thing that really holds it back from experiencing the true beauty and actual aesthetic of Rapture and Columbia is the 30 FPS cap, at least on the Nintendo Switch Lite port, as I mentioned. And that's, like I said, the one that I own in place, so I'm not exactly sure if it's different on the regular Switch. Now, maybe since I'm not well-versed or not used to playing FPSs on my Switch Lite, I feel that the gameplay controls are a little off, a little wonky, and the input delay is a little noticeable. It's not exactly game-breaking, but it's definitely noticeable. And you might actually see that within the background gameplay of the video. As far as game crashes are concerned, I've never personally experienced one, but I can definitely imagine that it would happen, especially during massive fights or if massive waves of enemies are coming at you at one time, because an overload. Now, let's go back to the input lag here for one quick second. Now, what do I mean by the input lag, if you are unfamiliar? So let's say you do an action in-game, where you want to look left or right. It might take another extra second or two for your character in-game to do so after you push the button. That's what's noticeable. You want to look left, it might take a little bit of a delay. You want to look right, up, down, it's a little delayed. That's what I mean. Still though, even with the game being locked at that 30 frames per second, it's still an awesome experience to be able to play a mobile version of all three BioShocks and their DLCs all of these years later, especially with the somewhat failed version of BioShock all the way back from way back in the day. Now I know I just knocked the game for not looking as good as it does, let's say, on console, but it's for a good reason. For this being a mobile, in quotes, port to the Nintendo Switch, the game itself still looks great, don't get me wrong. I can understand if the 30 FPS cap is a deal breaker for some people, and I can also understand if the 30 FPS cap is still frustrating, but it still looks good for it being ported over. Now, is the experience fun? Yes. If you're someone who's constantly on the go and you don't have a console, let's say PS4, Xbox One, PS5, the Xbox Series X, even the PS3 or the 360, this is definitely a must-own going into an on-the-go type of platform. So if you're not used to playing on a handheld device, let's say you're coming over from console or even PC for that matter, and you're not used to using the actual Switch itself, it's going to feel a little wonky, don't get me wrong, but it's still definitely a good experience. Finally, we're going to talk about my biggest gripe or biggest issue with the game, and that is the fact that all three take up a ton of space. If you're someone like me who frequently loves to save games just to avoid crashes, the SD card that you use will be filled up extremely quickly, unless you happen to get a large one. And it's quite frustrating to lose a lot of save spaces. It sucks to use up a lot of the storage. Trust me, I get it. That's why, for me personally, I use a rather large SD card. So I would recommend to you, if you can afford it, they're not too expensive. I believe one's $18 and the higher one is around $40. But I would say go with either a 128 gigabyte micro SD card or a 256 gigabyte micro SD card for that storage. The links to those will be provided in the description if you want to check those out, along with a link to BioShock the Collection as well, just in case you don't have it yet for your Nintendo Switch. Now, there is one other thing I'd like to say before I let you go today. I'm going to be doing a giveaway, and I'm going to be doing two giveaways actually. The other one is going to come in a different video. I'm going to give away a copy or two of BioShock the Collection on Nintendo Switch to you guys. So all you have to do to enter is like the video and leave a comment saying that you would like this game or the collection for your Nintendo Switch, and I'll do my best to pick a winner, get it out to you guys, and hopefully we can make some people happy. So hopefully that's good for you guys. I really want to give back. So to answer the question, is BioShock the Collection on Nintendo Switch still worth buying? I would still say yes, absolutely, especially if you want to experience this on the go. But be wary of everything that I mentioned in this video. The storage space, how the game's going to actually feel, the 30 FPS cap, be wary of that. I would say this is definitely a must own if you are a huge fan of the BioShock series, and hopefully if I give away a copy or two, I can help out and just give back to you, the community. So yes, this one is definitely a must own, but be wary of the issues that I brought attention to. I'm sure there's more issues, and I'm sure people will help me down in the comment section below. And for those of you who actually do that down in the comments, thank you very much. I appreciate all of you. So ladies, gentlemen, and everybody else watching, thank you all so very much for watching this video. If you enjoyed and want to see more, would you kindly drop a like, subscribe if you're new, and hit that bell to never be not notified about a future video or a future live stream. YouTube notifications are a little wacky sometimes, so that's the best way to never miss a video or a live stream. If you want to talk to me outside of YouTube or see any additional content, my social medias and my second channel links are down in the description below if you'd want to check them out. So with that being said, thank you all so very much for watching. Take care, stay safe, and I will talk to you all in the next one.